thanks very much, Joe Fowler. There you see Harvey Whippleman leading well done to the ring. Glad you're with us, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Ross and Gorilla Monsoon here with you once again. This should be quite a offensive-minded
tag-team
event.
Timothy Well and Stephen Dunn. They call themselves Well
on the right. Stephen Dunn, the blonde. And, of course, Gorilla, that's the little rat heart.
That little runt didn't take him long to barnacle himself to these guys, did it?
Certainly didn't. He is quite an opportunist. They're a very underrated tag team, and here's one that I know very, very well. That's Ricky Morton, his partner there, Robert Gibson. They are the legendary Rock and Roll Express.
Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson.
Smoky Mountain Boys.
The Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. I've known them for many, many years, and Bobby the Brain Heenan was exactly right. They have been a thorn in the side of Jim Cornette for about 10 years now, ever since Jim Cornette managed a team known as the Midnight Express, and they were a great team. Quite a rivalry exists between the Rock and Roll Express and Jim Cornette and whomever he manages, and of course the Heavenly Bodies Gorilla would love to have a shot at the Rock and Roll's Smoky Mountain Tag Team Championship belt.
I think everybody wants a shot at those belts. Almost as much as they want a shot at the WWF belts.
This should be an outstanding contest. Well done. Certainly would like to move up the ladder in the tag team rankings. They would like to eventually have the opportunity, no doubt, to wrestle for the WWF Tag Team Championship, currently held by Jacques and Pierre, the Quebecers.
Two foreign misfits, my book.
And Rock and Roll making their World Wrestling Federation debut. And we again are glad that you are with us. Hope you're having a great weekend.
Top tag team in the World Wrestling Federation right here. I think everybody.
Harvey needs a shave and maybe a bat.
For sure.
Referee Bill Alfonso trying to convince these four athletes that he would prefer only two in the ring at a time.
Well, that's the way it works.
Fans here not really pleased that Harvey is in their vicinity.
That's my wife right
here. Collar elbow tie up, and it is Stephen Dunn forcing Robert Gibson back in the ropes only momentarily.
Look how quick Gibson is.
Gibson very quick and very athletic. Nice counter move there.
Whoa.
Nice hip lock takeover.
For every hold is a counter. For every counter, a recounter. It's endless. It just goes on and on.
Well done trying to bring Gibson out of the corner. Can't quite do it.
He didn't want to go. I don't blame him.
Nice hip lock takeover.
Look out.
Gibson goes upstairs. Nice head scissors. Flying head scissors by Robert Gibson.
I don't see too many of those anymore.
Thanks in his partner, Ricky Morton. Look at this move. Almost a modified Frankensteiner there. Morton a real fireball. He's got a lot of intensity, but he stopped there momentarily. Again by Stephen Dunn.
Yeah, those are great moves. However, they miss one of them. You're in deep trouble. Reverse monkey flip. Nice.
Gibson, Ricky Morton takes down Stephen Dunn. Broadcast. Wait a minute. There's
trouble. There's trouble.
What's he doing down here? Jim Cornette. Jim Cornette, who hates the Rock and Roll Express, and the feeling is mutual. Cornette here with that tennis racket has no business out here at ringside.
Let's get him out of here.
Got a huddle going on here. Talking to Harvey and Well Done.
Get out of here with that camera.
He wants some privacy. Well, he'd like for Well Done to take care of the Rock and Roll Express here. That's pretty obvious. I'm surprised.
Lucky didn't get counted out.
I'm very surprised to see Jim Cornette here. I did not know that Cornette was here in the arena this week.
He's everywhere, Jim Ross.
Yeah, we should have. I should have known. I should have known by now. I've known him a long time. Still to come to broadcast, The Undertaker will be in one-on-one competition. Also, Bonnie Blackstone talks to Bam Bam Bigelow and Luna Vachon. Smoking Guns are here. Tatanka, Adam Bomb, and much more. Side headlock as Stephen Dunn controls Robert Gibson.
I'm your finish, you idiot. Get out of here with that.
And another attempted counter there. Tag made. Gibson tapping in Ricky Moore. Drop kick.
Nice.
And Moore's got the lateral press.
Right on the money, but the referee not there.
Cornette. Up on the apron, distracting the official. And Ricky Morton better look behind him.
Now, why doesn't that constitute a disqualification?
Well done now. Double teaming Ricky Morton. Morton clothesline here on the outside. Jim Cornette distracted the referee long enough for Well Done to gain the unfair advantage. There's a lateral press, and it's not over.
It was close.
It sure was. A very close near fall situation here. And you can hear the crowd in the background chanting, rock and roll, rock and roll. More double team offense by Well Done. Ricky Morton in a lot of trouble. Boy, Jim Cornette's got to love this gorilla.
Well, he loves it indeed. The more stuff he can stir up, the better he likes it.
Reverse chinlock by Timothy Well. And there you see Cornette and Harvey Whippleman. I didn't know there was so much polyester still in existence. Not saying Cornette and Harvey together. And again, look far across the ring. There you see a better shot of it. Ricky Morton being a double team.
The two of them together don't have $30 worth of clothes on, including their watches.
And what a unpredictable tag team matchup we're seeing here this week. Morton got buried right in his gut, and his neck snapped right off the top ring rope. Ricky Morton, I'm lying in the ring in a heap. This should be all. Leg is hooked and a near fall.
Came right out, shot that right arm right out of there.
Let me tell you more about the Survivor Series in this hour as well. With Joe Fowler and Bobby DeBrain Heenan and Timothy Well has Ricky Morton grounded. Morton's great quickness, no asset right now. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got to take a timeout. Don't you go away. The tag team action continues right after this. Stephen Dunn and Morton exchanging right hands.
Holy mackerel.
Boy, this one is firing up here. Irishman noise reverse far side. And Morton up and over power slam.
Didn't get what he wanted out of that, but nice maneuver anyway.
Ottawa's over. Welcome back, everyone. Jim Ross and Gorilla Monsoon back with you. The Rock and Roll Express making their WWF debut. Well done. Now managed by Harvey Whippleman. Jim Cornette at ringside. Cornette and the Rock and Roll Express, as we documented, as many of you know that have followed over the years, they have a real rivalry, a legitimate hatred for each other.
And rightly so. Look at that. Well, you saw only moments ago those two key brains locked together there.
Referee having to restrain Robert Gibson. In the meantime, look at Well Done. Taking advantage of it. No tag was made there, ref.
Well Done. Showing me something here, Jim Ross. They've got as much continuity at this point in time as the Express does. I'm surprised.
You know, I think they're probably one of the most underrated tag teams in the WWF, referring to Well Done. Timothy Well, reverse chinlock on Ricky Morton. And I've seen Cornette-led teams and the Rock and Roll Express and some phenomenal, phenomenal tag team matchups in the Superdome, in the Orange Bowl, the Forum in Los Angeles, the Marriott in Oklahoma City, just in great arenas around the nation, and they're always just scintillating tag team matches. And quite frankly, I think the Rock and Roll Express may be one up in the series.
Whoa.
Double team elbows there. Exchange made. Stephen Dunn, lateral press, and a near fall.
Well, the Express, they know each other so well. They can determine each other's moves before they're even attempting them, or before they're even entering their minds. That comes in experience.
It sure does. They travel together. They've been regular tag team partners for many, many years now. Ricky Morton, a second-generation wrestler of sorts. Gorilla, his father was a referee for 20 or 30 years down in the Tennessee area.
That'll give you a lot of insight. Hope he didn't take any lessons from the referee we're looking at right now.
Reverse.
Inverted.
Inverted atomic drop. the reverse whip to the ropes, and Morton comes up with a big offensive move that may give him the opportunity here to make the tag.
He made it.
Stephen Dunn got the tag, and Timothy Well in. Irish whip, far side. Morton over the post. Ricky Morton struck the steel ring post with his shoulder there.
I don't understand that move, Jim Ross. Ricky had an opportunity to make the tag in the corner, chose not to, and he's hurt. I don't understand that kind of thing.
Yeah, he made a tactical error there. He made a mistake, no doubt about it. You know, another thing that really sticks in Cornette's craw is the fact that the Rock and Roll Express have the Smoky Mountain Wrestling tag team titles. And Cornette would love, he would dearly love for the Heavenly Bodies to wear those belts again. Whip again, far side. This time, Morton able to avoid the contact.
Telegraph that move all the way across the ring.
Ricky Morton needs to make the tag. He is hurting. He is having to really reach down here.
Right there, pointed in the right direction. There he goes.
Morton tags in Gibson. And Gibson sends Dunn for the ride. High elevation. There's your back body drop.
Nice. Look at Gibson. He's on fire.
A couple of hard right hands, and their heads crack together. Rock and Roll Express regaining a firm advantage here over Well Dunn. Well Dunn rammed together. And Rock and Roll Express, are they about to put this one away? There's a flapjack. Nice move.
What a header.
Double drop kick. Vintage Rock and Roll Express. This one's got to be over. Double drop kick. Hey, ref.
Come on, ref.
Wait a minute.
No.
Cornette driving that tennis racket right into the ribs or the arm. I couldn't see it for sure of Robert Gibson.
Caught him on the forearm.
And Cornette now running like a... like a coward, the coward that he is. Cornette tripped and fell. And Robert Gibson has Cornette right where he wants him, Gorilla.
Get him, Bobby.
Wait a minute.
Oh, no.
There's the Heavenly Bodies stomping away at Robert Gibson. The Heavenly Bodies stomping away at Robert Gibson out here on the floor.
Let's get some help out here.
Cornette lashing. Gibson with that tennis racket.
Look at him, he's wide open.
Oh, right in the throat. The Heavenly Bodies and Cornette, along with that tennis racket, really doing a number on Robert Gibson out here. Ricky Morton finally out here to check on his partner. The referee back in the ring. Now, what's going to happen here? Gibson is the legal man in the ring. The referee is counting.
He's going to get counted out.
Robert Gibson, and it's over.
What a debut.
Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies,
as a result of a count,
have cost the Rock and Roll Express a victory here in their WWF debut.
Well, I think you can blame that all on James E.
Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies have cost the Rock and Roll Express a countout loss here in their WWF debut. And the war continues. Let's go back to Joe and Bobby.